Good morning, Triton. This is March, and we're mad, so I'd say March Madness is in full swing.
This weekend kicks off the Sweet 16 of the NCAA tournament, so how are your brackets doing?
Before the tournament began, we asked you to predict who would win the national championship. There have been a lot of upsets so far, so let's see whose predictions could still come true.
Know what it is. Some madness and badness. Combination.
What's up, guys? I'm Andrew with VTV, and today... Yeah. All right, I'm going to do that again. Yeah. And today we're going to be asking people, who do they got winning March Madness? Me, personally, I got Kentucky. I love Rob. Most of you probably don't know who that is, and that's okay. We're going to ask people and see who they got. Who do you got winning March Madness?
I got Gonzaga bringing it home this year.
Super valid, super valid. Who do you got winning March Madness?
I got Yale this year.
Wow. What?
Lexa, do you have any idea what March Madness is?
Is it football?
Next!
After you, please.
Thank you.
Okay, after discussing this with Mr. Noble, he has assured me it's going to be Samford. That's right, Samford, who's going to win today over Kansas.
St. Peter's, you know.
What?
Vermont.
What?
It's always Vermont.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
I'm gonna take Tennessee.
Bro, I'm out, man.
UConn.
UConn. A lot of UConns today. A lot of UConns. Who do you got winning March Madness?
Duke. Kentucky. Rob Dillingham. The best player in college basketball.
Who do you got winning March Madness? She said, let me in.
What?
They're not in the tournament.
BayPath University.
I don't even think they're in the tournament, but we will take it. As you can tell, most people picked UConn because they won last year. That's not valid. You never know. That's why it's called March Madness. And this is Andrew from VTV signing off.
Ramson Kennel is a family-owned doggy daycare in Salisbury with close ties to Triton.
Adeline Stapleton is a member of our VTV crew, and her family owns and operates the kennel.
There are also Triton students that work there and Triton staff members who board their pets there.
Such a big, happy Viking family.
Welcoming or loving?
Fun.
Passionate.
Adventurous.
Fun.
I'm Adeline Stapleton, a sophomore at Triton High School, and my mom is a small business owner. We as a family, but mostly my mother, own and operate Ramson Kennel in our own backyard. It was a little scary when we first purchased it, but it's really come along and it's a great place to bring your dog. It's a boarding kennel, so dogs, when they go, or their families go on vacation, their dogs come and stay here with us. With their own little vacation, and we can run them in our big yard, fenced in, feed them, take care of them for as long as their owners need.
I'm Caden Fowler, and I've worked at Ramsey Kennel. Working at the kennel is like tasting a rainbow. Owners of Ramsey Kennel are probably the best people on the planet. Bob and Jill Stapleton, like, wow. We really get a hoot out of the dogs here at Ramsey Kennels, especially Lucas Tinkham and his good friend Bagel, who is no longer with us here at the kennels.
My name is Jill Stapleton, and I am the current owner and operator of Ramson Kennel. We took over Ramson Kennel in December of 2019. The hardest thing about starting the business was probably the fear of the unknown. Just not knowing for sure what the customers were going to be like, how they were going to treat us. Those all turned out to be just fears, and none of them were really founded. We have an awesome customer base. We love our clients. Because our clients are so great, our dogs are great too, so we've never really had a major issue. Do what you love, I would give as advice to entrepreneurs. Our passion here is dogs, but whatever your passion is, you can turn it into a successful business.
My name is Bob Stapleton. I work at Hammond Lumber in Rochester, New Hampshire, but I will soon be retiring and working here at Ramson Kennel. What I like most about the kennel would be working with all the different dogs. All the dogs have different personalities, and just like people,
So with Ramsden Kennel, I would say they're really, really good about answering texts. If I have a question about how the dogs are doing, they're very flexible and they take really, really good care. Like the owner of Ramsden always has a funny story or a picture. And I know she really loves our dogs and that makes a big difference. I think my favorite part is just knowing that my dogs are going to have an awesome time. They're going to come home tired and I know they're going to be safe. Nothing but a hound dog, you're crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine. Well, they said you was high class. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, they said you was high.
Red Bull gives you wings.
I don't know what I'd do without my Red Bull in the afternoon. It's a great pick-me-up after lunch to get me through the end of the day.
That commercial was part of an assignment our VTV vets were given to research a company brand and produce an ad that either focused on the company's mission, one of its products, or its customers.
Nice job, Mia.
Up next, Riley Ann Tarmey is well known on the Triton campus for breaking the gender barrier and participating in the male-dominated sports of football and wrestling.
She doesn't just participate, she dominates.
As a freshman, Riley won Cal title with Triton wrestling team and didn't stop there. She placed third in the state and went on to compete in the New England Championships.
I'd say she made quite the splash in her first year. Up next, Riley vlogged her experience at New England's.
Good morning, Vikings. Today is day one of New England's, so yeah, come along with me for the trip.
I'm just saying, hey Mona Lisa, come home. You know you can't roam
as
without
I
Caesar.
Recall, I know you notice.
We have made it in the car. We're just gonna go to a half day of school, come back afterwards and do what we need to do and go to Rhode Island.
Update, I'm back in the car. We just went to Dick's to get a knee sleeve for my mat burn. We are going to go to Pearson's Plaza to go meet up with the coaches and Doug. Let's get on to it.
All right, guys, we made it to the hotel. I got my hair done out with like a helicopter. I want to put in the scale back in this box. So we're about to go downstairs and about to leave. It's 6:30. I need to be in the arena by 8.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it, screams from the haters. Got a nice.
I had my first match of the day, and I lost. I had another match in 30 minutes, so it doesn't matter. And now we're in the consolation bracket, so I'm going to be wrestling for third place, but I'm going to have a lot of goals. Just walking away.
We ain't got nothing to lose, everybody we rolling. Everybody we rolling, with some light skin girls.
Update. I'm done for the season. Had a match and I lost. I blew it. I was losing anyways, didn't get the pin. That is no one. That's the season. Season's over and then I go put the Smitties Monday in the off season. So, thanks for watching.
Peace, Vikes.
Podcasts are a pretty popular form of entertainment for our teachers, but us teens, we need something more visual to keep our attention.
That's why Mr. Lathrop assigned our first year students video podcasts this quarter.
Each group had to pick a theme, plan a rundown with talking points, film for 10 minutes, and then edit the final podcast down to a 5-minute time limit.
Sit back and enjoy the episode 1 of Keeping It Real podcast with Riley, Elena, London, and Juliana.
Hey guys, welcome to the first episode of Keeping It Real. I'm Riley, and we're going to be talking about like ghosts and like paranormal activities and just stuff in that genre. The first question I'm going to be asking is like, where do you guys like stand? Like, are you guys like skeptics or believers? Are you guys like just like don't believe?
I believe in the Holy Ghost. Personally, Jesus, I am 100% a believer. If you don't believe, then get out.
I think I'm a believer, but like I feel like there's a chance that like couldn't be real, you know?
Maybe it's just all like, a coincidence.
Like,
I agree.
I'm in between. Okay, and then like where like on a scale are you? Like on like a scale of 1
like,
to 10?
Low key like 8.5. Like 8.3.
Yeah. Okay, that's not bad.
8 solid. 8.0.
I feel like honestly, like, I'm, like, a 9.9.
Okay,
because, like,
wait,
I just think
okay.
that there's, like, just, like, a percentage, like, maybe, like, because I, like, nothing's really, like, too bad, like, happened to me that I'm, like, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Like,
okay. Juliana, what do you think?
Yeah, what are your thoughts?
Yeah,
Juliana?
What are your thoughts on this?
I don't know. I don't really have any thoughts.
Are you, like, boring. Are you believing in this, like, nonsense we're talking about? Yeah. Or this, like, yeah. This isn't even nonsense.
Then, okay, I wanted you guys to share, like, some, like, experiences that you've had. Like, even if they're, like, really minor okay. or whatever. Just, like, something, like, brief, you know?
All right, I've got a story, guys. It's about my mom, and she was, like, 14, and she lived in this really old house. And she kept, like... So she was in her room one night, and every single time she went in her bed, it would, like, shake. Her mom, or her friend was going downstairs, and my mom was just on her bed, and she was, like, by herself in the room. And all of a sudden, the bed was, like, like shaking, and my mom started screaming. My friend was just like, all right, I want to switch rooms with my sister so that maybe it's just my room that's, like old and like the floors are creaking.
Yeah.
But the spirit like followed her to her sister's room, and then her bed just like kept shaking.
Yeah, I would have ran out of there if I was your mom.
I would have called the police.
Would have dipped. Definitely would have dipped.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Ready? So this was like a few years back. I was probably like 10 or 11. And I was in my house, and I was in my room, and I was having a sleepover with my older cousin. And we were like, sleeping, and all of a sudden, it was, like, 2 in the morning, and all of a sudden, she's shaking me. She's like, get up, get up. And I'm like, what? And she was like, someone's in here. I'm like, what do you mean someone's in here?
Oh, my God.
And she's like, I keep hearing my name. It's like, her name's Amy. She was like, Amy, Amy, Amy. And it was like, she was like, it's not you. Get up, get up. And I'm like, what? And she goes, maybe it's my brother, like, because my brother was in his other room. But then we go to my brother's room, and he's sleeping. So we're like, who's in here? So, like, we stayed up till, like, 6 in the morning, just, like panicking. Like, and we still don't know who it was, and it just kept doing it.
Did you hear her?
Yeah.
Or did you hear the voice?
I heard it after she said it. It was like, Amy.
Okay, now I'm, like, actually scared. So my mom grew up in, like, this, like, really big house, like a big house in, like, Linfield. And so she, like, had the top floor, like, all to herself.
Ooh, lucky.
I know. But yes. So I remember she told me this one, like, when I was younger and, like, freaked me out so much. So apparently, like every night, like, she went to bed and it was, like, dark out and whatever, she'd see these, like miners. Or, like, I forget, she said, like, miners? Or, like soldiers, but they just like she see like a shadow of them, like
brought up like the skinwalker thing.
No,
I think those are like I don't That's actually scary. I'm watch something happen to me, but like I don't really believe in that.
And so I'm gonna pull up a picture.
Okay, it's not like a thing. It's like more like it's like being like possessed by something, or it's like taking over. Like I don't know.
And it's like hello. Why is it like a horse?
Oh,
should
no.
they possess or disguise themselves as an animal?
So I was talking this about in the car with my dad one day, and we were talking about how like little kids and like animals are like more like prone to like see like like ghost and whatever. Yeah. Like, you know how, like, kids will say, like, oh my god, there's, like, a monster, like, in my bed. Like, they,
yeah,
like,
there's
actually,
a monster,
like,
in my closet.
Like, apparently, that's, like, kind of, like, a gift that, like, not, like, a gift, but, like, something that you just have when you're little because you're, like, more, like, open to, like, that idea than you are, like, an adult.
Like, believe in, like, deja vu.
Yes.
Like have
absolutely.
A dream.
Absolutely.
I've been
absolutely.
Having awful deja vu lately.
You had a dream and you're, like, oh, I already did that. And, like, you thought you did it, but you never did. So, mm-hmm. It's, like, what? And like, do you believe in like spirits? Like, you know, say like someone passed away, they come to you in your dream.
I
do believe in that.
I like am scared of that happening to me. Like,
thank you guys for watching Keeping It Real, and I'd love to hear some of your stories. And yeah, bye.
TikTok challenges are all the rage these days.
At least until TikTok gets banned by the government.
Don't get me started. Where am I going to sell my dog hair stuffed pillows now?
Curses! Up next, a group of our freshmen take the blind karaoke challenge.
Let's see how they did.
Hey guys!
Hey guys!
It's Penelope,
Olivia,
and Carly
from VTV, and we have our special guest.
He is Bailey!
Today we're going to be doing the blind karaoke challenge.
Yes.
So let's go!
So how this works is one person puts their back to the TV.
And then one of us chooses a song that they have to guess the lyrics to.
This is my family, a whole translation. There's no stars and everyone. This is the performance. Can you repeat? Drop the rosé.
What you got? A million times you never thought, hey.
Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed watching us do blind karaoke.
We had so much fun, so you guys should totally go do this with your friends.
For VTV, I'm Carly.
I'm Penelope.
I'm Olivia.
And I'm Bailey.
Well, that's it for our show. Thanks for taking the time to watch it.
I'm Riley.
And I'm Aubrey. Go get your dog hair stuff pillows before the shop closes!
Hashtag furry friends pillows for life.
This is a bad day to do it because I'm sick. Are you sure I'm centered? I feel very left.
Yeah, I feel like you are very... I feel like...
He's lying.
He wants you out of the video.
I know. Good morning, Trayan. This is March, and we're mad. So I'd say March Madness is in full swing. What? What? All right,
good?
We're good. We're great.
All right, here we go.
I'm going to punch you in the face, Riley.
I was a little upset this morning.
Ready? You were upset this morning?
My mascara came off. TikTok challenges.
Yes, good job.
TikTok.
You can't say the word TikTok.
TikTok challenges are all the rage these days.
At least until TikTok gets banned by the government. Riley McDonald. Well, that's it for our show. Thanks for taking the time to watch it.
I'm Riley.
And I'm Aubrey. Go get your dog hair stuff pills. I'm gonna punch you, Riley. Go get your dog hair stuff pills before the shop closes. Go get your dog hair stuff pills before the shop closes. Oh my god! Go get your dog hair stuff pills before the shop closes. Oh my god!
I physically can't.
Yes, you can.
No, I can't. Hashtag furry friends pillows.